What I want to explore in this video is the notion of a rate. So let's look at some examples of rates that you've probably encountered in your everyday life. So if you're driving in your car down the road and you're looking at the speedometer, you might see that it says that you are going 35 mph, where the mph stands for 35 miles per hour. Well, what's that saying? That's saying, well, every hour, how many miles are you going if you were to stay at that current rate? So it could be a measure of speed. How much distance are you covering per unit time? And most typically when people talk about rates, that's what they're talking about. They're talking about how much of something that is happening per unit time. And it doesn't have to be even distance per unit time. You might have your hourly rate for someone who's doing some type of a job. They might say that they're making $10. So they're making $10. And actually, let me write the dollars out so the units become a little bit more obvious. $10 per hour. Dollars per hour. And so once again, this is how much money, it's not talking about distance anymore, how much money is being earned per unit time. And so even though rates are often associated with how much something is happening per some unit time, and it could be miles per hour, or it could be meters per second, or in this case, it could be your wage, it could be dollars per hour, rates don't have to be just in those terms. In fact, you might say, all right, I have a dessert that I really enjoy, but I'm very conscientious about the number of calories that I consume. And you might see something like there are 200 calories per serving. And so this is telling us the number of calories per serving, and they'll tell us what a serving is. A serving might be a cup or 8 ounces or whatever else. And so I could say, okay, look, if I have two servings, then I'm gonna have 400 calories. Same way if I work 2 hours, I'm gonna have $20. If I go 2 hours, I'm gonna go 70 miles. So rates give you a sense. It's like how fast is something happening, or how much of one thing is happening for every time something else happens. Now I can write rates so they look an awful lot like a ratio. And these words are actually very related because you see that even how they're written, R-A-T, R-A-T. Their roots are coming from the exact same idea. In fact, this rate over here, 35 miles per hour, it could come from, hey, I just went 35 miles in 1 hour. What's the ratio? So the ratio of miles 2 hours. And then you could say, well, if I went 35, it's the ratio of miles to hours was 35 to 1. Or it could have been, maybe it was 70 to 2 or something like that, but that could have been reduced to 35 to 1. So as a ratio, you would typically see it written like this, or maybe see it written like this. And sometimes you might even see it written like this, 35 miles to 1 hour, but now it's starting to resemble more of the special case of a ratio, which we call a rate, because this is the same thing as 35. Instead of writing it out miles per hour, you'll often see it written like this, miles per hour. So these are very, very related ideas. If you find the ratio between calories and servings, well then you are going to be able to express it as a rate, and vice versa. Now, why do we care about rates? Well, especially if we're thinking about things like speed, without rates, it'd be hard to quantify how fast things are happening. Otherwise, we'd be in a world where we're saying, hey, I'm faster than you, or she's faster than me, but we wouldn't be able to quantify exactly how fast they are. But with rates, we can say, hey, that person ran 100 meters in 10 seconds, they run 10 meters per second. We can quantify exactly how fast that thing is happening, the rate at which it is happening. Here, instead of saying, hey, a cup of that is gonna give you more energy, or be, you know, or maybe contribute more to your weight than a cup of that, and making these relative comparisons, here you can actually quantify things. And when we study rate, we're gonna study rate a lot in mathematics. It's gonna be essential in algebra when we look at the rate of change of a line, how far it moves in the vertical direction relative to the horizontal direction. We're gonna call that slope. And you could even imagine a slope of a hill is kind of how fast is it climbing for as much as you move forward. But we're also going to study rates in detail when we go to calculus. In fact, the whole basis of differential calculus that you might see later in high school and early college is all about measuring instantaneous rate. How fast is something going right now? So rates are really, really interesting, really, really important. And I would guess that if you just look around your life, even over the next few hours, you're going to encounter many, many, many rates.